can they, if they use voice consonants a little bit better, mm-hmm. that will help with that line. They chop the sound off to make the consonant. And that's a musical theater. I was in musical theater first. So it's something you don't want to that pad, especially in pad. But they really take you to a teacher. That's why they make them like they need to take she presses on the which is, yeah. Mm-hmm. She's opening up that belt better. It's getting lighter and brighter. I'm trying to get her to get that tongue out a little bit more and get her posture. Yeah. I'm going to do some body mapping this week to see if that helps, because I'm aware of the posture, but it's so totally different. And it doesn't matter if I'm aware of it.
Right.
So we have a conversation with my wife. How do you have to do something to check in? Because mm-hmm. your posture should not be like mine. Would you have a friend and discover more? So I'm going to work a little bit more on that. And she has some stress. So there's been some negative symptoms that I've addressed a few weeks.
So we're from.
Oh, wow. It's just life. So I'm like, you know what? You carry that energy that you are. Now I'm a woo-woo teacher, but that woo-woo energy is going to fit your woo-woo voice in ways that you don't understand. And so,
do you see her rose?
I told Natalie. I'll make it very nice. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. Welcome to St. John's Cathedral. We are so thrilled to have the Gonzaga University Chamber Singers here today for their send-off concert. And I do want to highlight this beautiful program. If anybody needs one, I can bring you one as soon as I'm done talking up here. I'm the music director here at the Cathedral, and we have been delighted to do some collaborations with local institutions offering this space for them to sing in. And so we're thrilled to have Dr. Meg Stolman here and the Gonzaga University Choir Chamber Singers. If you would silence your cell phones or other beeping devices, that would be fantastic. This is being live streamed, so you can be tuning into this, of course, via Facebook. It's on the St. John's Cathedral Facebook page if you wanted to come back and see it again or share it with some loved ones that maybe didn't catch it the first time. So welcome, and I'll hand the mic over to Meg. Thank you.
Thank you guys so much for coming. I'm Dr. Meg Stolman, and this is my first year at Gonzaga University, and to be mounting an international tour is quite a feat, but this has been a long time in coming. Raise your hand if you're a senior. So this is amazing for them to get to do this before they graduate, to get to do a tour and go to Italy. We are lucky that we have a campus in Florence, so we'll get to spend part of our time in Florence and part of our time in Castiglione, which is a small town a couple hours away from Florence. We hope you enjoy your program. It's my spirit sang all day, so every piece of music is something about bringing joy and the spirit of all the places that we're getting ready to go. So thank you so much for coming.
Seriously.
Hello.
I did break it, didn't I?
The first song, as you heard, is the theme for our concert. The next three songs you're going to hear are sacred pieces of music from the Renaissance period and all have connections
to the Gonzaga family and to the what was being sung and performed in the courts when the Gonzagas were
helping to support musicians. I hate
microphones. Hello?
Hello.
Music stand is close to you.
It is. I don't want to knock it. Okay. So, if you could name one Italian composer from the Renaissance, what's a name you might have heard before?
Palestrina.
What's another one? Monteverdi. Monteverdi. But have you heard of Jacques de Vere? Have you heard of Salome Rossi? You have not. They all worked at the same time.
So you're going to hear a song by each one of those composers. Next. I'll stop talking.
Oh,
try. Okay. I'm so proud of them. This music is very far away from a lot of the music that we do nowadays. And to be able to do a piece in Hebrew that was written in the Renaissance is very unique. Salome Rossi's music is beautiful, but not as many people know about it as they do about Monteverdi. So part of the reason we go on these tours is for the students to experience being in the places where the music was originally written and the spaces where the music was written to work with the acoustics. So the fact that we get to take this music with us and have those experiences is something that I think is a life, only once or a few times in your lifetime you get to do it. And to have a student who just got recognized for their work in Hebrew is kind of awesome, because they made sure that I didn't suck at the Hebrew, so it was good. The last piece in this set is Gaudete in Domino, which is technically an Advent text, but it's by a lesser-known composer, Jacques de Vere, and it's just beautiful. So this is one of their hardest songs. So send them love, because they've been working really hard.
I'm gonna sing till the spirit moves in my heart. I'm gonna sing till the spirit moves in my heart. I'm gonna sing till the spirit moves in my heart. I'm gonna sing till Jesus comes. I'm gonna sing till
my Jesus moves
in my heart.
I'm gonna sing till my Jesus
moves in my heart.
I'm gonna
sing till
my Jesus
moves in my heart.
I'm gonna
sing till
my Jesus. Till he comes,
I'm gonna sing until
my Jesus
moves in my heart. I'm gonna sing until
my Jesus
moves in my heart. I'm gonna sing until
my Jesus
moves in my heart. I'm gonna sing until
my Jesus comes.
Till he comes,
it was grace that taught me,
my Lord.
It was grace that taught me,
my Lord.
It was grace that kept me,
my Lord.
It was grace that will lead.
I'm gonna pray till
my Jesus
moves in my heart. I'm gonna pray till
my
Jesus moves in my heart, so I pray till the Spirit moves in my heart, so I pray till Jesus comes.
Featured two of our amazing tenors, Robert Waltenbaugh and Ryan Bass. We give them some more love, it was awesome. This next piece is by a modern woman composer, Reena Ismail, and it is in Hindustani. It's actually, what she wrote is it's written out almost like scat for Northern Indian music. But the first word, the tuta, is like in Italian. She put the rana, which is the Hindustani word, with tutti from Italian. That means all sing. That's what this piece is about. And it's just hard as nails, but fun. And we hope you enjoy tuta rana.
Ta-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- I'll pass that.
I told you don't give me a microphone because I like to talk. Okay, if you have come in from that side, you may have noticed the row of stuffed animals and what in the world is happening today. So as you can see, this program is hard and varied in styles, in time periods, all of the things. And we have not always been positive about our ability to complete this project and do so in the way in which we feel we should, right? I have overachieving children behind me, if you did not know that already. You don't go to Gonzaga because you want to skate by, because the parents are paying good money for their children to go to school there, and they worked really hard. So we had some moments where we were down on ourselves. So I brought in a little pig from a book by an author in Seattle. And he's a flying pig. And he wears a little helmet, like a pilot's helmet. And it's all about anything is possible. And his name is Maybe. There he is. So Maybe is going on the trip with us, and that inspired some more animals. So we now have a crew that will be coming with us, and I know there are more. So anyway, I just wanted you to know that about us, that this has been a journey for them and for me. That last piece pushed me too. It's been really hard. But the next piece you're gonna hear, How Can I Cry, is I think a really important message for us coming from a privileged society like in the United States. This piece was written by the composer after she spent time in one of the refugee camps in Greece and felt like she wanted to help and didn't always know what to do. So as musician, she responded with writing a song. So How Can I Cry?
Ten.
All right, we have one more song that's in the program, and then if you're nice, we'll do a bonus song. Just because we might like you. Thank you for that golf clap. That was magical. I feel seen. I do want to say that on the very last page of your program is a little bit of information about the choir, if you're not a family or friend, and an opportunity if you feel so moved. A QR code is there if you'd like to give a donation. All the money that would be given would go directly to the students and to their trip. It does not go to me, it does not go to the program. It goes to support their experience that's happening in 2 weeks. So if you feel so compelled to do so, we would be very grateful for you. They are paying for a portion of their trip themselves. So this is a big lift for many of us to do this. It's, as you can imagine, it's not cheap to take 23 people to Italy right now. But anyway, we're just so excited to do this. We have one more song that's in the program. It's called Never Let Go. And one of the things we've talked a lot about this year is that all music has meaning, all music has value, no matter if it's from the Renaissance or if it's from a pop performer. So Rob Dietz, who wrote this piece with his wife Stephanie, writes mostly pop a cappella. So this is the style that you're gonna hear it, but the text I think is quite meaningful, so hopefully you'll be able to understand what they're saying. But this is Never Let Go.
To grant us. There. Yeah.